Hello friends, welcome to Electronic Circuit Hub. So today we will understand op-amp crystal oscillator. We will see the basics of crystal oscillator and then we will see the application of crystal oscillator. Alright. So the most accurate and stable type oscillator uses crystalline feedback loop to control the frequency. So the crystal oscillator is most accurate and stable type of oscillator. This is the equivalent circuit diagram of crystal. This is the symbol of crystal. This is the physical part of crystal. And this is the internal structure of crystal. Okay. So, what is piezoelectric effect? Right. So, quartz is a crystalline substance which exhibits a property called piezoelectric effect. So, here you can see a quartz material is being used to form a crystal. Right. When a changing mechanical stress is applied across the crystal to cause it vibrate, a voltage developed at frequency of mechanical vibration. In conversely, when a AC voltage is applied to the crystal, it vibrates at a frequency of applied voltage, right? The most vibration occurs at the crystal natural resonant frequency, okay, which is determined by the crystal cut and the physical dimension of the crystal, okay, which is determined by the crystal cut, how crystal is being cut and what is the physical dimension of this quartz wafer crystal. All right, so this is the internal structure of crystal and this is the physical part of crystal. A crystal consists of a quartz wafer mounted between two electrodes. It is mounted between these two electrodes and enclosed in a protective can. This is the protective can. So if you look the crystal, your final product will be like this. All right. So this is the equivalent circuit of crystal equivalent circuit, right? It can be operated, crystal can be operated either in series or parallel resonance, right? At series resonance, the inductive reactance will be cancelled by the reactance of Cs. Then RS determines the impedance of the crystal. This is condition for series resonance. And in parallel resonance, the inductive reactance and the reactance of parallel capacitance are equal. In parallel resonance, the inductive reactance and the reactance of this parallel capacitance are equal. So in parallel resonant frequency is at least 1 kilohertz higher than the series resonant frequency, right? So let's say if series resonant frequency is 1 megahertz, so at least your parallel resonant frequency will be higher than 1 kilohertz of this 1 megahertz, right? The advantage of crystal is it is exhibit high Q. Okay, so this is the advantage of crystal because it is having very high quality factor. All right, so this is the crystal series resonator. You can see a crystal is connected in the feedback path, right? Okay, and a capacitor is connected in series with this crystal to tune the resonant frequency up and down, right? The सीरीज रेजोनेंट फ्रिक्वेंसी इज गिवन बाय 1 डिवाइड बाय 2 पाई अंडर रूट एल एस इंटू सी एस. दिस टू टर्म्स केम फ्रॉम इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट ऑफ क्रिस्टल, राइट. क्रिस्टल पैरेलल रेजोनेटर. सो यू कैन सी हियर ए क्रिस्टल इज, दिस इज बेसिकली ए टाइप ऑफ कॉल्पिट्स ऑसिलेटर एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ इंडक्टर वी यूज्ड हियर ए क्रिस्टल, राइट. वी यूज्ड हियर ए क्रिस्टल. सो यू कैन सी ए क्रिस्टल इज यूज्ड हियर अलोंग विद दिस टू पैरासिटिक कैपेसिटेंस लोड. यू कैन से द लोड कैपेसिटेंस टू ड्राइव ए क्रिस्टल, राइट. सो दिस इज इन्वर्टिंग एम्पलीफायर एंड दिस विल गिव 180 degree phase shift, okay, and this feedback circuit crystal and this capacitor will give another 180 degree phase shift. So you will have here 0 degree or 360 degree phase shift at your output, right. The frequency of parallel crystal resonator is given by Fp, which is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi under root Ls, okay, into Cs multiply by Cm divided by Cs plus Cm, alright. So mode of oscillation in crystal. So basically crystal oscillate in two mode. One is fundamental mode. In fundamental mode, the lowest frequency at which naturally resonate. This is the fundamental mode. In this mode, the crystal naturally resonate at its lower frequency, right? It is less than 20 megahertz. In overtone mode, for higher frequency, crystal must be operated in overtone mode. It is odd multiples of fundamental, like 3, 5, 7. So here frequency is very high. Now we will see the application of crystal oscillator. So this is the most commonly used application in the industry. A crystal is used in microcontroller and microprocessor, alright. So you can see this is the crystal. This is the load capacitance C1 and C2. And you have two pins in microcontroller, oscillator in and oscillator 1 and oscillator 2, oscillator in and sometime it is called oscillator out. So the crystal can be found in the range of 1 to 20 megahertz, and the value of this load capacitance vary with this crystal, and it could be in the range of 15 picofarad to 30 picofarad. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any question, feel free to ask me in comment section.